sellers, or I'm also in the role of the other client. I use the graphical presentation of the PowerShell. For me, it's like more friendly. There's a transition from everything graphical to kind of scripting again. I used scripting a long time ago, but for the last 20 years, I'm a Windows guy, so I used to the graphical presentation, and I don't know, it looks better to me. But it's just a matter of what you like, what you prefer. You can type, you can do the stuff in the PowerShell without the graphical interface. There are caveats with the graphical interface. Not all the commands actually work in the same way. So if you receive an error, try the same command just in the PowerShell script itself. In PowerShell. That may not solve your issue, but in 50%, that's how it was solved. You go to the normal PowerShell, run it, done. You go to the graphical, run it, error. I can't explain that, but it is what it is. So you look at your environment. It takes like only a few seconds on my machine. It may take a little bit longer on the slower machines, but it's there. And then usually I like to go to directory where I do my stuff. I create a folder. This is where I do my processing for the extensions, all the files, and I want to be in that folder. I don't want to be in the root folder of the system, just over there. It simplifies things for me. You can do it different way. And on the top, you can not only highlight it, script. So I don't run all of the scripts of the same run. I can highlight and run just a single one. I think it's convenient. You prepare the script and you run line by line when you have to, or you highlight several lines and you execute several scripts at once. It depends what you want to see as an end result of that. Because sometimes you will get an error and you don't know which one script failed. Run one by one. I don't know if you can see it. It's really small. There is a command to export all the objects. There is a command to export, modify. It's for all the slides and all my presentation. Those have taken time. It can be 5 minutes, it can be 10 minutes. It all depends on how hungry you have. So we'll skip those two steps because they consume most of the time. We'll go directly to the compare of your original files and modified files. And for that, I'm going to delete the deltas in my system. So I have no delta. I have modified folder. I have original folder with the files. No delta. And I'm going to remove actually my test as well. So I have no extension, no nothing. Just two sets of objects. And we'll execute compare of two of these sets. It goes to, basically goes and matches, it's a match, it's a match. And it's done. So we have delta. And here's my delta. What it tells me, equivalent is 50,000. I introduce that volume, so it comes in as a text, because it has to contain all of the changes I made. Basically, the entire volume. 50,001 as well, complete. Page 30, it's only built. Let's look at the build. It's small, but you can have an idea. It's only the differences, what you change in the basic copy. And the only thing I changed, I added action. Actions are allowed for extensions, but not code. So if I have an action, then I can subscribe to that event. When somebody clicks on that action, I get an event, and I subscribe to that, and I do my processing, and I'm popping up another page. You want to do the comments? Get the comments. So, and that's true for every other delta I have here. Only pages, and the rest of the files, like for the page, for the table, because those may introduce as extension objects, those are cool. They are text files. They have a complete solution of these objects. So now we have everything prepared to actually package our extension. So we create the manifest. We give the name, we specify the publisher, we do the short description of the extension, and we also need to provide a version of that extension. By default, it's 1.0.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1.0.1. run that script, it's done. Let's look at the file we just produced. It's XML file. That's how it looks. Nothing special, just a manifest of your extension. I have a manifest, I have deltas. I'm ready to package my extension. I run the script. Boom. There is a package created. And if you look at that, the package has extension as .navx. That's true only for v1. Don't be confused. It's not navx. As a navx, it's navx extension. We can look at that file as well and see if we can actually make sense of it. Yeah, it's not readable. So sometimes I can't read that. So this is the actual file. We're going to publish. This is our package for the complete solution. So the next will be to actually publish and install the extension. So let's look at our system. Let's look at our system. It connects to the demo database, no extensions. Not my extension, I'm sorry. There are default extensions already. To publish your extension so it's available to be consumed by end users. I highlight the script, line, command, and I run the publishing of the extension. What it does? changes the data schema in your system if it has to change. For example, you extend the table, it will add that extension to that table schema. There were other sessions with the details last year, even of these directions, what are the differences. V1 combines together all the extensions, like you design extension, somebody else design extension for the same table. All of these extensions will be changing the schema for the table, and they will come together. So they're basically a combination of all of them. They're all.
So if you zoom on your record,
yeah,
from the client, you'll be able to see all the movements from all the atoms that your table.
When you publish the extension, it will be added to the list of available extensions which you can install,
right,
and consume.
No, but I mean, if you have new records that's been introduced by several extensions,
yeah,
if you on a specific record and you want to zoom on your client, will you?
After you install them, maybe.
After you install them.
And publishing is available for installing, but not available yet for using.
Okay.
And installing itself is available for use. Make it available.
The question was, when you publish and install, for example, your
after all that,
or multiple extensions for the same area, like same table.
Right.
And when you zoom, are you going to see those fields? The answer is yes or no at the same time.
We can check.
Because there might be some difference. I don't know. If you zoom it in the designer,
you can.
Good question. I never thought about that, but
about the page.
You can see it. That's a good exercise for today. I didn't have that in my mind. Like, well, if I use an extension, I use it. But the data is not saved directly in that table, like not in the customer table. It's saved outside. So there's no direct visibility to extensions data. If you need to design a report, those fields are not visible to you. You see only the basic customer table. Yes, you can consume on the pages and code units of that extension, the fields introduced by the extension. But to design a report or do something more challenging, it has some tricks you can use, but it's more difficult than V2. That's why I have, yes, V1 is good, but V2 probably is better. At least we're going in that direction. So we run that script. So now my extension is available to be installed and consumed. So the publishing basically gives me an availability of that extension. And if I then refresh, I even don't have to refresh, it's there. Not installed. So this is the line, and this is the my extension of the file application comment extension, whatever it is. And I'm not going to use actually PowerShell script to install. I'm going to the NAV client now, and I say, yeah, I want to actually try that. And before I do that, I go to the items and I look what is available for me in the navigation. In the navigation, I have my comments.
you can reach.
So small that I cannot see my laptop. So the comments, there's only one section for the basic comments in the system, like as we used to. No changes, it's just there as a basic code. As you can see, there are no any additional stuff on the Python core. So I'm going to install an extension. Click install. Yes, I want to install and install. It says the extension is installed. You have to close and open your client.
Schema changes.
Some changes because I was already in the functional medias. And I look again at the item card, navigate. Oh, maybe I have location comments. I click, and what I can do is it looks exactly the same as the basic comments for the sake of the exercise. And I put the comments. And it's going to be location mode. No, it's Boathouse. I don't want to use actually Boathouse for the sample. Boathouse active? No. Okay. Go to the blue location. It's not Boathouse activated. I don't want to go through the Boathouse and shipments and packages. No. Okay. I have just one line of code here, and actually for any other locations, or all the locations, I want to have like a basic comment. Welcome. Nah, 2018. So those are the location comments I have for the bicycle. And the exercise was to have actually those comments to be available only on the post sales invoice. So we go directly to the sales orders. We create a new order. I will use my login customer.
It's a number. Sales order. In navigation, we can see there are only basic comments.
section, just really the none. And we run on the sales lines.
Related information. In the related information. Okay. Line related information. There are comments.
There's none. We didn't add that section over there. So it's easier to add, it's just modification for the sales order support. That's all. So we come to an overview of what we have, we need to start on documents. And I guess we're ready to post this, there's the release for connections. Yes, because this is what my extension leaves. So on the line, I have location comments. Bingo. Those are my comments. Now I say, here we just saw how easy when the extension is published, how easy to install it, uninstall it, even through the whole delivery client. And even use PowerShell on purpose, just for the visual difference. You can do everything in PowerShell, but that final step you can do actually in the client, in front of the client. Click the scripts to install, uninstall, and publish. So the final one, because we already did installation and uninstall of the extension, is actually to unpublish. So it's no longer available. And I run the script. And I'm going back to my client. I look at the list, it's gone. So that's the life cycle of deployment or unemployment, whatever you call it. And our shell scripts. There was another article, how to develop extensions, available on the web. The PowerShell or the PowerPoint presentation will be available after directions. You can probably figure out yourself if you Google, but those are the links. Now with you, most of you probably already heard that it's available. It's coming in a month. How many of you two will be acceptable for the Dynamics 365 in the cloud? For Dynamics 365 on premise, you still can do V1 and convert to V2. You still can do, I think you still can do your hooks in the code on premise. There is no restriction for that. But again, make your code clean. friends and walk around. If it's not possible at the first glance, maybe you have to start fresh. Have an idea of what you need. What is your current medication, customization? Rethink of the design and do it differently. For the end user, whatever you do, they see only page, report. They don't see you're putting in the back. So, good time. There is a very useful NAM development preview blog article. There is a later September update, so you can follow the entire structure, like blog articles from the beginning, where they started, and every month they have a new release, new preview, new information available. There is a Visual Studio Code introduction and extension to introduction. That's an old article, but those are the starting points. Again, if you're not comfortable with V2, start with classic V1. Try it, do whatever you need. Test, okay, everything's working. There is a conversion tool from V1 to V2. Do it, see how it looks in V2. Again, there are limitations. Not everything is supported yet in V2, but those are out of the scope for this session. So the message is, get ready. I guess that's all I have. Any questions if I can answer them?
If there is reason.
Going one, going two, three. Yes.
If I wanted to retrieve new functionality from the most recent releases and compare that to a previous release and create an extension for that, theoretical example, take NAV 218, do an original base, take NAV 217, do an original base, and then we compare
the
two.
You're talking about changes in the basic code. That is not allowed in the...
So you can't compare two versions of NAV?
You can compare versions with a PowerShell script. You can do all of this, but you cannot do extension out of them. Like, the
ends of the code.
We're going back to a different topic. Upgrade. Upgrade steps are exactly the same. But there is one more set. You have your source, unmodified system, NAV 2009, no modification. You have your 2009 customized system. You have your target, which is NAV 2017. So those are the three databases you're targeting.
Mm-hmm.
So you will get all the sets of objects. The compare will go and match changes here, there, and produce not the delta at that point. It will produce the complete files. However, there will be issues, and you have to address them. For example, you deleted something in 2009 customized system, or added something. But then there is a conflict because the basic NAV did something similar. So you based on the field which is no longer available in 2017. Sorry, you have to fix it.
Okay, but let's say we're using two original variables.
Yeah.
No modifications.
Yes.
It's only a comparison between the old and the new. And I want to achieve certain components of the new version. Bring it across to the previous version without migrating or upgrading. I just want to cover and retrieve certain functions.
Here, can you get closer? Yeah, I can answer this question.
Thank you.
Could take it offline.